What we want is all of this information to come out so that transparency can reign supreme and accountability can occur.
That is House Speaker Paul Ryan talking about the story of the day, the classified memo on the Russian investigation written by Republicans on the House Intelligence Committee. It is expected to be released as we speak. It has not been released, and the White House says it's unlikely it's going to be released. This is something that is overshadowing the State of the Union
big
tonight.
Time.
But this concerns the Russian investigation, and it's an investigation of the Justice Department and the FBI. What say you?
What say I, Robert, is when you have the, and people need to know the origin of the intelligence committees in the first place. They were created as a check and balance on the intelligence committees coming out of the Church hearings, Senator Frank Church hearings in the 1970s. And as a result of that, there are certain things that you expect in a bipartisan manner coming out of these committees because they have privy to classified information.
But this is highly partisan.
Oh, this is 13-9.
It's the Republicans 13-9. The Republicans are releasing it in favor of releasing it.
And it's just the House doing
no.
it, Robert.
And
the Senate
the House,
has not
right,
done
it's
that.
It's the House Intelligence Committee, chaired by Devin Nunes,
correct.
Who was a member of the Trump transition
team. Who also
team.
Had to recuse himself from all things Russian. Congressman Mike Conaway has been serving as the interim, not of the committee, but of the chair looking into a lot of this Russian stuff. So I want that as a backdrop. The partisan nature of this release, which, by the way, they invoke some rule, Robert. I'm sure you're aware of
yes.
Rule 10 within the House rules. Never been used before, by the way.
Of course
to
not.
Send this to the president for a 5-day wait period. So if the president does not sign this, it automatically is declassified. He must reject it out of hand. Look, at the end of the day, I think this memo should be seen by the American people. It's information related to what the Justice Department did in getting warrants or whatever through FISA court. But at the same time, it should be done in a bipartisan manner. We shouldn't be, you know, Democrats and Republicans on this issue.
And the Democrats have their own memo they want released.
Yeah, and it will be. It'll just go through the same thing of having members of Congress view it the same way this one was. Then it'll go through the whole chain of events again. Look, at the end of the day, Robert, the Intelligence Committee was not set up to be partisan committee. It was supposed to be bipartisan. You remember Congressman
he would always say, I work with Republicans. And
Mike Rogers, the chair of Mike Rogers.
Yes.
They
had a good working relationship.
And they did joint press conferences. We've seen the same thing in the Senate with Senator Richard Burr, who's a Republican, and Senator Mark Warner, who's a Democrat.
Right.
This is just bad. The whole optics of all this are bad.
You also get the sense we're never going to get the truth of what happened in terms of possible Russian interference.
Well, I disagree. I think Robert Mueller and his investigation will definitely get to the bottom, I believe, of what happened. It's just going to take a while.
But if the president is constantly discrediting that, who are we to believe?
Robert Mueller. And I think if you look across the board at most Americans who they have faith in through this process, the credibility of Robert Mueller, not only as special counsel, but as former FBI director, as number two in the Justice Department, I think that reigns supreme.
It is State of the Union night. Very quickly, you're going to have to go home and take a nap because
yes.
you've got the pregame coverage.
Orange juice.
But
yes.
What do you expect?
What I expect President Trump to do is focus on the economy, a lot talking about his tax law, the benefits people will be seeing in their paychecks in a couple of weeks, as well as when it comes to their tax returns. I expect to talk about infrastructure and the fact there's a $1.7 trillion infrastructure package he would like in a bipartisan way for Democrats and Republicans to pass. And I expect him to mention the wall once or twice, Robert Lang. I think he might mention DACA and the wall. February 8th is right around the corner. We may have another government shutdown.
That's right. That's
a week from
Thursday. C4 will have
Thank
the
you,
pregame
Mr.
for tonight's State of the Union at 8 o'clock. You will hear the speech and the Democratic response from Congressman Joe Kennedy at 9 o'clock. Andrew Langer has the postgame with your calls at 11 o'clock. We will replay the speech in its entirety at 1 a.m. And C4, of course, will talk more about the State
yes,
of the
I
Union.
Yes, I will.
And we'll have coverage of Governor Hogan's State of the State tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090.